Hey everyone, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to talk about the Z-Image Turbo all-in-one version. Basically, we are going to combine all three components into one checkpoint. In other words, we are not going to have a separate VAE and text encoder. Everything will be packaged into one checkpoint. Few things to note about this model. It is still the Alibaba version. It's still 6 billion. We have the photorealistic image generation fast, 80 steps, just like the original version. And it can still do bilingual English, Chinese text rendering. The only difference here is the integrated VAE and text encoder. So there's no need to download separate files. It is also 8 GB VRAM friendly. There are two versions of this model. There's the FP8 and then the BF16. In summary, the FP8 version is smaller in size. It's going to be a faster download. It will fit in 8 GB VRAM card, and you will still get that excellent quality from Z-Image Turbo model. BF16 is twice the size of the FP8 version. You will get the best quality, but you will need a little bit more processing power. If you want to try out the model right away, you can use these settings. I will talk about the workflow a little bit later on. Let's take a look at a couple of example images I've generated using these models. This is the 1024 by 1024 example generation. And on the left side, I have the FP8. On the right side, I have the BF16. To be completely honest here, when I generated these two images, I could not find any differences until I added the image comparer. And I was using the slider to find the differences. Basically, if you take a look at the mouth here, it's closed. On the BF16 version, it's slightly open. There's slight differences between the necklace as well. This one is a little bit incomplete, the FP8 version. The BF16 one, it's, I would say, completed in the generation. Other than this, I don't see much of a difference in terms of the skin quality, texture. So if you need that extra space, FP8 version would probably work just fine for you. This model excels at 4 megapixels. So that's going to be 2048 by 2048. All of these images are that resolution. Let's take a look at the same prompt here, the Latina prompt. Left side, I have the all-in-one BF16 version. On the right side, I have the separate components, basically the original version. Now, once again, I don't see much of a difference other than the person pose and the person themselves. The image quality is pretty much the same in both versions. Where I was able to find noticeable difference is when I generated anime style images. On the left side, I have the all-in-one BF16. On the right side is the separate component. And in this one, I can clearly see the difference. So left side version has more noise and it's not as sharp as you would expect from anime style. The right side is pretty much perfect. We can see that it's sharper and there are no noise. Everything is clean. Now the disadvantages are still there. So it's still none of the versions were able to generate long text. And for context, this was my prompt. As for shorter, simple text, it can do that without any issue. All right, here's a quick guide. Download the model, place it inside the checkpoints folder, and then load it like you would normally do. For those who need that extra help, I will have a link in the description below. It will take you to Hugging Face page. Click on files and versions. You'll get these two versions here, and you can see the size. The FP8 version is basically half the size of the BF16 version. Click on these download buttons to download them. Most likely it will be saved in your downloads folder. You will need to place it inside of ComfyUI models checkpoints folder and then place your checkpoint in there. Now again, in the description of this video, you will get a link to the workflow. You will need the Z-Image Turbo all-in-one.json. Download it, drag it on top of ComfyUI. It will load everything. Press R on your keyboard to reload the node definition. Go into the load checkpoint, click on the drop-down box, and then select the version that you've downloaded. I have the BF16 pre-selected. Next, depending on the amount of VRAM you have, you can enable or disable this image scale to total pixel. By default, I have it set to 4 megapixel. This is the ideal image size that you want to generate at. But if you need a smaller resolution, you can always bypass this node and then enter your resolution at the top. The rest is similar to the original workflow. We are still doing 8 steps. CFG, sampler, and scheduler stays the same. You can do a test by clicking on the run button and you would get an image similar to this. Note that the default workflow will generate a 2048 by 2048 resolution image. Now quickly, I want to point out the Turbo Union ControlNet model. In the last video, some of you mentioned that you were getting error with the model patch loader. And I mentioned this in the video, you will need to update your ComfyUI. If you've updated your ComfyUI by simply changing the update type to nightly version and updated like this, and you are still getting that error, then I'm going to recommend you go into your ComfyUI. If you have the portable version, go inside update, then double clicking on update underscore ComfyUI.bat. This will ensure that you have the latest commit. If you do not have the portable version, then go inside the ComfyUI folder. At the top here, you can type in CMD. This will open the terminal directly at that folder path. Then type in git pull, press enter, and you should be able to update to the latest version. If you've installed ComfyUI in a different way, then you will need to look into how to get the latest version. Basically, any error that you're getting from the model patch loader will be solved once you update to the latest version. All right. That is it. This is the all-in-one version of the Zimage Turbo model. If you have any difficulty, let me know in the comments down below. Thank you for watching until the very end. I would like to say a big thank you to everyone supporting the channel. Have a nice day. Take care. I will see you next time.